Hello friends, so here comes part 4 of my presentation on business interruption policy. In this presentation, I'll be covering policy clauses, specifications, and other terms. And another one is departmental clause. This clause is very important. And it says, if the business is conducted in departments where the independent trading results can be ascertained, then loss of GP can be calculated separately for each department affected by loss. So the only condition is that the independent trading results must be available. However, this is subject to a condition that if the sum insured under the policy is found less than the sum total of all values reduced by multiplying the rate of gross profit with the respective turnover of each department, whether these departments are affected or not, then payable amount shall be reduced proportionately. That means it would attract under insurance. Now it is very interesting to note how this under insurance is calculated. Now we continue with the departmental clause. So it is summarized. In nutshell, this will mean insured must have more than one production blocks. That is quite logical to get benefit of departmental clause. So unless he has got more than one production block, this clause cannot be given, and it should be in one compound. And each department, this is very important condition, each department or section or production block must have proper accounting system to evaluate their respective rate of gross profit and annual turnover, etc. So for each department, if the insured is maintaining separate books of accounts, then only he can take this particular clause. Now the third important point is the loss of GP shall be computed based on accounting figures of affected section. So the loss shall be computed not based on the overall figures of the industry, but it shall be calculated based on the individual figures of that particular department which is affected by loss. But the adequacy of sum insured shall be checked by comparing the declared value, declared sum insured, with the sum value, sum of the values arrived by multiplying the rate of gross profit to the respective annual turnover of each department, whether they are affected or not. So in the next example, we will understand this clause more clearly. Now there are a few more things before we go to the example. In absence of this clause, the loss shall be computed based on overall average value of rate of gross profit and reduction in turnover. That means this clause can also be used in case of group companies where a single policy is taken by the holding company, provided the financial accounts are maintained independently by each company. So what does it mean? If there is a holding company which has group companies, many group companies, and each company has got separate trading results maintained separately, which is done in most of the cases like Siemens, ABB, etc. In that case, this departmental clause can be given to such policies where the trading results are separately available. And in that situation, in the event of a loss, the loss will be computed based on the accounting figures of that particular company. In such case, each group company shall be considered as department, and a single BI sum insured is declared as a combined BI value for all group companies. Now let us understand this clause by way of example. Now you see the example. We have assumed a risk has three departments and your block A suffers a loss. Then loss shall be computed based on the individual values of A, based on its rate of gross profit and reduction in turnover, as we have already discussed, by way of learning the method of computation of loss. But this is, we are not discussing this. What we are discussing under these circumstances, how are we going to apply under insurance? Now we see this is block A, which is affected by loss. Now the rate of gross profit is 10%. Annual turnover is 60. So the multiplication of these two, 60, 10% of 60 comes to 6 crores. For block B, figures are changed slightly. Annual turnover is 160 crores and the rate of gross profit is 15%. then it comes to gross profit for this individual block individually, it comes to 24 crores. And for block C, it comes to, by multiplying these two values, it comes to 50 crores. So total comes to 80. Now we see the sum insured of the policy is taken as 40. So insured is under insured under these circumstances, and the assessed loss of block A shall be reduced to the extent of 40 by 80, that is 50%. Now next clause is accumulated stock clause. This clause says where the insured maintains sufficient stock of finished good depending upon the nature of industry, and the insurer, in that case the insurer may attach following clause to the consequential loss policy which are issued on turnover basis. So this facility can be given only to those policies which are issued on turnover basis. Now this clause reads as under. It says, while computing BI loss, if any shortage in turnover due to the damage is postponed by utilizing the accumulated stocks of finished good in the insured's warehouse, then necessary adjustments shall be made. What does it mean? That insured is trying to maintain supplies by making use of stocks which are already there in its godown. So in that case, we will make necessary adjustments. So now we read this. This means reduction in inventory level of finished good shall be considered as reduction in turnover during the indemnity period, and it shall be added to the actual reduction in turnover witnessed by the insured during the remaining indemnity period. Now let us see the example of accumulated stock clause, and we are discussing two cases. Case 1, ABC company suffered a major loss which stopped the production activity completely, but it was found in order to maintain the supplies to the customers, insured utilized the stocks worth rupees 50 crores from their finished good godown in order to avoid reduction in turnover during the interruption period of 3 months. Now here in this case we have assumed that insured resumed production after 3 months, and this was well within their indemnity period, which was for 12 months. Now let us understand the importance of this clause. So first of all, had this clause not taken by the insured, surveyor would have denied payment of loss based on the fact that there was no reduction in turnover. Actually, if you see the net result, there was no reduction in turnover. Actually, he maintained this reduction in turnover from the storage stocks, but for the surveyor there is no reduction in turnover, and this is the primary condition for admissibility of BI loss. So surveyor would have denied this claim. Now since this clause was attached, so in this particular case, despite there was no production inside the plant, stocks were utilized to maintain the sales turnover during the indemnity period. So what is the conclusion? This 50 crores stocks which was utilized for maintaining the turnover shall be considered as reduction in turnover for the purpose of calculation of BI loss, and the loss shall be paid accordingly. Now here is case 2. What it says? Now in second example, what we see? That despite utilizing accumulated stocks, insured was unable to avoid complete reduction in turnover. That means what? Inventory was not sufficient to maintain the turnover throughout the indemnity period. And in this situation, the reduction in inventory level, that is 50 crores, which was sufficient in the previous example, here it was not sufficient, and that is why it shall be added to the actual turnover for final computation of loss. That means even after utilizing 50 crores inventory, he could not maintain the turnover for the entire indemnity period. And that is why here is the example. Now you see under case 2, this is the example. ABC company takes BI policy with 9 months indemnity period and with accumulated stock loss. A loss takes place on 1st of January, resulting in total shutdown of production activity. Plant restarts and restores production levels on 15th of July after complete repairs. Here the insured could maintain sales and avoided reduction in turnover utilizing the stocks of finished good worth 50 crores only till 31st of March. That means till 31st March there was no reduction in turnover, but after then he suffered reduction in turnover till 15th of July, which is the date of restart of plant. Now under these circumstances, if the actual reduction in turnover, that means for the period 31st March till 15th of July, is 150 crores, then the computation of loss, total reduction in turnover shall be 200. We will have to add this 50 crores into the actual reduction in turnover. Now we will discuss professional accountant's cost and auditor's fee clause. So this clause says that the company shall pay reasonable charges paid to the professional accountants for submitting such details of any proof or information as required by the insurance company in the course of processing the BI claim. That means in case insurance company demands some proof or details, in that situation the company would pay the reasonable charges which are paid by the insured to the accountants. Further, this clause is subject to the condition that total of BI claim and the professional accountant's cost should not exceed the sum insured of the policy. And the third thing is, it should be clearly understood that this extension does not cover the cost of preparing or arranging for details, accounts, etc. That means claims preparation cost is not covered under this extension. Fines and penalty clause. In some of the trades businesses, the manufactured goods are to be supplied to the customer possibly before an agreed date, and a provision is made in the contract of sales and supplies for payment of fines or damages in the event of delay in supplies. So under this clause, insurer shall pay for penalty and fines for which insured becomes legally liable to pay for non-completion or late completion of orders solely due to an accident at the insured premises caused due to an operation of insured peril. So that means if because of accident the contracts are not completed in time and insured is legally liable to pay some penalty to the clients, and in that situation that amount shall be compensated by the insurance company. Now this is very important clause, that is new business clause. This clause is applicable where the BI cover is granted in the very first year of operation. So this is a tricky situation. In the first year of operation, you don't have any previous data, that is you don't have a standard turnover, you don't have annual turnover, you don't have last year financial year turnover. So it becomes very tricky to calculate the BI loss. So this clause is attached in such policies where the BI cover is taken for the first time. In order to process the claim occurring before completion of first year's trading results, the terms rate of gross profit, annual turnover, and standard turnover, they are modified as under. So rate of gross profit is, the definition is revised. It says the gross profit earned on the turnover during the period from the date of commencement of business till date of loss. So in this case, what we do, if the loss takes place after 6 months from the commencement of business, so the turnover generated by the client during this 6 months period will be taken as the turnover, full turnover, and the gross profit earned during the period of 6 months shall be taken as gross profit, and this GP so arrived divided by the turnover shall be the rate of gross profit. Now let us talk of annual turnover. The definition is revised as under. The proportional equivalent for the period of 12 months of the turnover realized during the period from the date of commencement of business till date of loss. Now if you see the example, what it says, if the loss has taken place after 3 months from the commencement of policy, the annual turnover shall be 4 times of actual turnover for 3 months period. Now why we have multiplied by 4? Because 3 months period turnover we know, and now annual turnover definition is modified and it says proportional equivalent for the period of 12 months. So If this 3 months turnover is to be multiplied by 4, it will be proportionate equivalent to 12 months period. So after multiplying by 4, the figure you get will represent your annual turnover. And the third is your standard turnover. So here the definition is again revised. What it says, the proportionate equivalent for the period equivalent to the indemnity period of the turnover realized during the period from date of commencement of business till date of loss. Now if you see the example, if the loss takes place after 3 months of the commencement of policy and IP selected is 6 months, so now what the definition says, your actual gross profit earned during the period before date of loss should be proportionately increased to match with the period of indemnity. Now you see, since the indemnity period selected by the client is 6 months, we have turnover of 3 months. So if we make it double, it will become a standard turnover. So here comes the end of part 4. And now in part 5, I'll be discussing policy memos. There are 3 memos. I'll be discussing that. Some special conditions, exclusions are there. And then I'll be discussing policy specifications. And that would be the end of this series. Thank you.